Man, let me tell you something, man. Every one of you son bitching Americans should be either horrified, scared as hell, or cleaning your damn weapons up at the way this damn government is just either incompetent or malicious. Either way, man, it's ridiculous. What we supposed to forgot that last month or two? Oh, man, hold on. Let me get my thoughts together. Man, I'm about to blow a gasket. Hold up. Okay, yesterday, all throughout the news, all I see is clips about getting vaccinated. Disneyland got a measles outbreak. Hold on, it's Disney World in Florida, Disneyland in California. Now, I was in school for psychology, and we talked a lot about studies, longitudinal studies, and correlations, and this and that. Okay. Now, have we forgotten that a couple months ago we had this influx of children from South America coming to the country? Now, for all you idiots out... Hold on. Okay, do you remember Ellis Island, where immigrants used to come into this country and they would go to Ellis Island to make sure that they had no diseases? A lot of diseases we eradicated, so we're not going to just let anybody come in. I don't got nothing to do with being racist. It's about being a diseasist. I'm a diseases, and we used to have people get checked. Okay, y'all forgot a couple months ago that we let all the kids in on the death train from South America. Now, first, that's a whole nother story. First off, I say, if a little kid come knock on my door, and they say, I want to come live in here, and I just let them in, no, I'm going to look around and be like, man, where your damn parents at? So the first thing I said when I saw them kids coming up here was, damn, what country are they coming from, and what the hell is going on down there that make them come here? But in America, see, we done got so accustomed to dealing with the symptom instead of the source. So the symptom of the kids coming were the kids being here. And we ain't never addressed the source. We don't know where they come from. And not only that, the clown President Obismo positioned the kids where they couldn't be seen, or no one knows where they were dispersed into the country. Okay, so we were supposed to forget about that. Now, here it is yesterday. I'm watching the news because I like to laugh. Whenever I want to laugh, I turn the TV news on. And everywhere I see measles, Disneyland, measles. Not one story about the illegal kids coming into the country. Not one story. Now, and I keep hearing, you got to get your measles shot. What about the damn Hispanics that come from Latin America? Did any of them get any shots? They didn't get any shots. Then that might be the source of the problem. It might not be. But hell, we won't know because we have no information on their whereabouts. Now back to the Disney World is in Disneyland, California. California's a lot of immigrants, right? So maybe the correlation there is the kids may have spit. I mean, when you come to the United States or you win a big event or you do something major, what's the first thing they make commercials out of it? I'm going to Disney World. I'm going to Disneyland. Hell, if I was from Latin America and I come up here and I always heard about Mickey Mouse, first thing I'm going to tell the people that's catering to my needs is, let's go to Disneyland. Now, ain't nobody said nothing about these kids coming into this country. But now all of a sudden you want everybody is damn near mandatory to be vaccinated. Man, what is going on in this schizophrenic ass country?
Ha ha, WBUD, Channel Colossus. East up in this thing. We're gonna talk politics. We're gonna talk about war. We're gonna talk about love. We're gonna talk about entertainment. We're gonna talk business. We're gonna talk about pulling pants up. Yeah. Put on my Malik Che Nesta helmet. You know what I'm saying? Malik Che Nesta. WBUD. Get into my Minister of Information stance. 44.7 Radio Rebel Day. We're gonna talk aliens. from outer space, not Mexico. Let's ride.
Okay, I've been able to sit around for a whole week and watch this whole dope show as far as the vaccine and the measles, and I mean, it's hilarious. I mean, nobody is bringing up the real issue, and that is the dosage. You know, now let me preface this by saying I'm not against vaccines at all. You know, that's how we all walking around, cleanliness, healthy. You know, I want my little seed to grow. So I'm not against vaccines, but I am against giving all the vaccines at one time. Now, from what I understand, you can barely get, or should I say rarely, or if at all, that you can even get the measles vaccine alone by itself. Now, what is that about? So, I mean, the argument, man, and you got people coming out, they're so stern about you get vaccinated. Where in the hell were these people when all these kids was coming to the country? And they don't know racism, nothing. Get the hell, I don't care if it was a bunch of dogs. And from what I understand, certain places that you come from, certain countries you come from, or certain cities that you fly into, certain states, your animals get quarantined regardless for a couple days, weeks. You know, I don't know, but I'm like, well, damn. So where's the argument at? Ellis Island, anybody remember that? So don't come with the, is you a racist? Race these. It's not about that, man. It's about health and safety. And I don't think that no other country on this planet would behave the way that we are behaving. So it's some ulterior motive going on, I think, personally. And it's funny to see people on the television or him on the radio dressed up. I heard a guy on Coast to Coast last night, George Norrie, on his radio station, and the guy was adamant about take your vaccine. And George Norrie asked the guy, do you take the vaccine? The guy said, no, my body is different from an illness. Wow, this the wrong spokesman for take the vaccine. I mean, simple as that for me, man. Cut it off. That's it. No, end of discussion. But people dressed up on television, take your vaccine, and it's like you don't want to have a discussion. And the tripping part is all y'all do is lie. That's all y'all do is lie. That's all you're known for is telling lies. The whole health government health administration anyway, the Center for Disease Control, known hereafter as the CDC. Come on, man, all y'all do is lie. Now, I'm gonna mix it in with this. You Negroes out there, you want to throw your hands up and yell, "Don't shoot!" I got one for you. Hands up, don't shoot me with your damn vaccines. Because if you Negroes want to be mad about something, I got one for you. I got a cat right here. William W. Thompson, Ph.D. Now, this was an August 27, 2014 press release, where this cat is talking about, hold on, let me preface this by saying I don't care what he's saying. You know, the first thing I say, well, is the cat really a doctor? And if he's a doctor, okay, do he work for the CDC? Okay, that's a little credibility for me. Okay, now, and this is what tripped me out. He say, regarding a 2004 article. Now, what I'm going to do, I'm going to put the article up. I got it up on the screen if you want to screenshot it or screen save it. I don't know about this damn computer shit. But whatever you want to do, you pause the video and read the article yourself. But it's up here. Regarding a 2004 article examining the possibility of a relationship between the MMR vaccine and autism. Now, he says that, I guess this was a 2004 journal article in the Pediatrics. I guess that's the name of the journal or whatever. But talking about how they withheld some scientific evidence about the MMR vaccine affecting young black babies at a different rate. Now, notice I said different because I don't know. I don't trust none of these studies. And all I'm saying is my man come out and break this news. He's what you would call a whistleblower. And you ain't heard a word about it. And you cast hands up, don't shoot. Hands up and don't shoot that vaccine inside me or my little kids. Well, you don't care nothing about that, man. That's you want to be mad about something. That's admirable, and you have the moral high ground to be mad about infecting the babies. But you don't want to talk about that. You thug life. Yeah. Anyway, back to the vaccine and your drug pushers, your drug peddlers, vaccine pushers. All y'all do is lie. There's no other way to explain it other than all you do is lie. Now you got the whole CDC and Ebola and everybody just lying, and you want to shoot something up in me or even worse up in my kid, and I'm supposed to just run with it. No debate about it. When you hear both 2, 3, 4 sides of the story, but you don't want to have no debate about it. Why? Man, I remember I had was talking to a nurse, and the nurse, I asked, I say, I heard that the flu vaccine that y'all give out is always the strain from the previous year. And she sat there for a second and she said, yeah, that's true. And I was like, wow. So I started asking about, you know, more medical things and the Ebola and this and that. And the first thing she said was, well, the CDC said, and I was like, damn, is this the same CDC? You referring to the CDC Tom Frieden, the idiot? Well, I ain't gonna call him. I don't know his credentials. But he's the Tom Frieden is the director of the CDC. And he just had a bunch of blunders with that whole Ebola situation and, you know, blaming the nurses for catching Ebola for not following protocol and then having to backtrack. And I remember he came back after the nurses jumped on him and he said, quote, my intention was not to suggest there was fault with the hospital or the healthcare worker, unquote. Now, a couple of days, I remember I saw this on the television, this cat talking, and my jaw fell out and hit the floor. And you did say it was the nurses didn't follow protocol, and then you just backtracked. And you also said you could treat Ebola in any hospital. Now, and that struck me as odd because I say, well, that should be right because all the money we've been kicking out for the war on terror, I know the hospitals are equipped with, like, gas masks and, you know, anthrax-proof gear. I mean, that's what we put all this money into the war on terror and being prepared. But come to find out, the hospitals didn't even have, you know, the little astronaut hazmat suits. Man, what the? Man, come on, man. And then the same time, Frieden say, we not going to stop the flights. I ain't even going to talk about Abysmal. But Tom Frieden said, we not going to stop the flights because that will bring about distrust amongst the countries involved or some nonsense like that. When every other country in Africa, every other country on the continent of Africa damn near shut their borders down. So, y'all not coming up in here. Well, but they were racist, though. They probably were racist. All them African countries was racist, you know. But this Tom Frieden, he say that we not going, you know, trying to rationalize not stopping flights from West Africa. Man, come on, man. You're a maniac, man. Real, y'all boys be getting the marching orders and don't even care how you come out, how you look. And another incident he had was with the talking about you can get on the bus. If you can ride the transit, you don't have to worry about catching it if you're on the bus. But in the same statement, he say, now, if you feel like you got the symptoms and you're sick, don't go out and take the public transit and risk infecting somebody. Man, whoosh, slap across the face, man. Shut up. And then you got another vaccine pusher, and that was, what was her name? Nancy, what is it? I got it right here. Let me see. Her name was Nancy Schneiderman.
The country, in deployment of the vaccine and in hand washing and covering your cough.
And look, this is one time. Forget the conspiracy. Listen to our government agencies. These guys are telling the truth. You know, there's no conspiracy here, folks. Just get your damn vaccine.
Now, she was her claim to fame was this was the lady who was sitting in the car in the Benz after she come from West Africa in the Ebola contaminated area, and you know she's supposed to be on a little self-imposed quarantine for the time allotted to see if the disease, if she had contracted the disease. Now, she gonna make a run to the, I think, like the sandwich store or something like that. You know, just gotta get a sandwich. But prior to that, you know, she was the one that Nancy Schneiderman during the H1N1. You probably forgot about that. That was a couple minutes ago. The H1N1 virus was supposedly running rampant. She was the one that came out and said, "It ain't no conspiracy, people. Listen to your government. Take the damn vaccine." Now she run around in from the Ebola area, West Africa, back here in the States, and making runs in the car. And you know, do as I say, not as I do. What's good for the goose is not good for the gander. But this is the same people saying, run out and take my baby and get her juiced up with your super potent vaccine, and I supposed to trust you. Tuskegee experiment, syphilis. Man, shut that. Man, I'm not even gonna argue with you, dog. I'm tired of talking about it and trying to sugarcoat it and be nice. PC these nuts. This is ridiculous, man. I'm supposed to trust you. All y'all do is lie. All you do is lie, lie, lie. Fuck, man. Trust me, and trust these. Trust. Yeah, what I do trust, I trust President Obismal, the lying Hawaiian, the maniacal antagonist. Yeah, I trust him to do something PR and simple as appoint an Ebola czar. Ebola. Hey, man, czar, czar. I thought czar, that was a word from like Eastern Europe, Russia, and all that. Czars. What is... the Hawaiian get all these czars from. But anyway, I expect him to appoint a czar, Ebola czar. Now, this is the guy he appointed on October 22nd, 2014, as the Ebola czar, Ron Klain. And Ron Klain is the former chief aide to Vice President Joe Bizzle Biden. You know what I'm saying? So Obama will point this. Oh, I said his name. Damn it. I'm going to take that out. Obismal appointed Ron Klain October 22nd, 2014. And it ain't nothing to say about this cat. Don't know one thing he did. From what I understand, the big roar about him was he never attended any meeting at the White House. So he came in October 22nd, 2014, and he will be exiting March 2015, so a whole 5-6 months. Now we got this whole Ebola thing in check. Trust me, we got it in check. You don't hear about no more cases no more. You don't hear about it. What? Oh, you heard about some cases? Look, man, y'all know that. Man, they covering this damn thing up. They covering it up. I got a cat right here from interview he did with InfoWars, and he not hiding his name or nothing. He putting it out there. Dr. James Lorenzi, and this cat got two clinics in Garden City, he got two clinics in Missouri, one in Garden City and one in Archie, Missouri. Now, he said that he was told by a doctor, he put his name out there, come holler at me, come talk to me. You know, some people ain't terrified of these estrogen-filled cats. But anyway, he was told, Dr. James Lorenzi was told by a doctor at Truman Lakewood Medical Center in Kansas City about patients that were coming in from West Africa, and one in particular that, you know, after one day or two day, they disappeared, and when they ask about the patient, They had the medical staff or whatever, the superiors at the medical staff, the governing body had a meeting and told all the staff not to talk about this. And they told the staff that the patient that disappeared, the feds came and got him, and he had malaria, even though he was bleeding out of all orifices and all that. But they say he had malaria and don't talk about it. They tell the first responders in New York that anybody that have Ebola-like symptoms, don't say nothing. Don't say it over the radio or nothing. So they covered it up. You think it disappeared? It's still raging like it was in West Africa, but it ain't nothing going on here. Man, come on, man. Hey, trust me. Yeah, okay, whatever. Yeah, y'all trust him. Tuskegee, give me some of that good syphilis.